Welcome everyone. So today I wanted to do a different type of video. I wanted to do a use case video. So people are always talking about use cases for smart contracts, for cryptocurrency in general. And I get a lot of different ideas and I maybe wanted to make this into a series, but I wanted to get some audience feedback as well. Let me know what ideas you have. But something that was very interesting in the last Cardano Effect podcast, episode 10, with Philip Wadler, he was saying that I pretty much came out and asked him about a particular use case, the interest rate swap use case for smart contracts within Plutus. And he was saying that the use cases for smart contracts have yet to be determined. So what does that mean? In the early days of the internet, I doubt that people understood exactly the scope of what the internet could provide. Rather, that the internet had to be built before solutions like Amazon, before eBay came on, before sites started using them to transact goods and services. But this use case wasn't familiar with the early internet creators. Rather, the platform is built and then developers come and then it's basically put out there exactly what is possible. And it's the exact same thing with Plutus. Plutus is going to be that highly functional programming language that's going to allow ease of use for developers, including Marlowe as well. So people can start building their smart contracts on top of Cardano. You know, if you are a Haskell developer, you can build in Plutus. If you do not have much programming knowledge and you work for a financial institution, then use Marlowe. There, Cardano is going to be offering the solutions that are going to require, or they're going to push developers to start building these solutions on top of Cardano. So I wanted to talk about this interest rate swap contract. So this is what I was thinking. So on the Plutus site, if you go to sample smart contracts, I believe, there's a little blurb about interest rate swaps. So interest rate swaps are basically swaps between financial institutions. So they are pretty much gambling on volatility of interest rates from a given time period. So say you have one bank that has, I don't know, $1 million and another bank that has $1 million. One is basically betting on the interest rates going up and they get paid. And the other one is betting on the interest rates going down and they get paid. So this could be monthly, this could be quarterly, this could be yearly, this could be weekly, this could be daily if the transaction speed was quick enough. But I think that with these interest rate swaps, running it on the Cardano blockchain, it's going to allow for funds to settle in a lot quicker period of time. So interest rate speculation is going to be happening on a minute scale versus like a major scale. So they won't have to wait for interest rates to close at on a monthly basis in order to collect their dividends from the other bank. They're going to be able to do that in real time and allow for money to be transacted in a much more seamless way. So one of the things that I thought was particularly interesting is people always speculate as to why hold this cryptocurrency token to start off with. So say a company starts building a smart contract within Plutus or within Marlowe, and why would that company actually hold ADA as a token? Why won't they just use the smart contracting platform and move on from there? Well, there are a couple of different ways you can look at that. You know, this could be a interoperable contract because Cardano is all about interoperability. So you could be transacting with your local fiat currency like the US dollar or Japanese yen and be interoperable between crypto and fiat. See, that's the problem with a lot of cryptocurrencies. You know, they may solve a solution, but is that actual institution going to hold it for a long enough period of time in order to provide that needed liquidity into that native token? So for ADA, if we have an interest rate swap contract, and let's say that it's running concurrently with an epoch, so that 5-day period, that staking period, when that closes, that interest rate contract closes. When it's run like that, then the bank or the institution that's running that interest rate swap contract, if they hold ADA as the native token, they could also be collecting staking rewards within that contract. So what if that contract is assigned to a staking pool within that given time period, and this gives them the proper hedge in order to, I don't know, collect that money? The losing party could be collecting money basically on that speculation. So what do I mean by that? The losing party could technically you know, if they're betting on an interest rates, let's say a couple percentage points or a fraction of a percentage point, and it goes in one favor and not goes in the other favor, but if the contract is being staked at the same time, like it's delegated to a staking pool, then the amount of money that they could earn could hedge against the volatility of ADA. So even if ADA is volatile within a couple percentage points within that given epoch, that could hedge against that. But that also can provide that institution with added liquidity. So they could actually be earning while participating in the contract. For other cryptocurrency projects out there, why would a company hold, or why would an institution hold that cryptocurrency when they are transacting in fiat, and the world is still transacting in fiat, and there's not going to be a change from fiat to crypto anytime soon? So especially, you know, we're touting ourselves as interoperable, so we're going to be communicating with the legacy system, but if we can offer an incentive to stay within our system, that's the differentiating factor. That's going to allow the institutions, that's going to allow the banks, that's going to allow the small mom and pops to be transacting within this ecosystem with relative ease. You know, like, they're going to, let's say they want to stay within this epoch for 5 days and they collect their staking rewards and they continue, and it's a hedge against the volatility of ADA in general. Of course, it's very volatile now, so it would need to decrease in volatility over time, but over time in the future, this could hedge against that volatility of crypto, and this could also bring an added incentive. And they could be collecting rewards while in a contract, and there's no reason to stay within that fiat system for that particular contract. Rather, it's good to switch the assets from fiat to ADA, and then, you know, interoperate back into the fiat system when they're ready to do so. But that given time period, that waiting to collect your staking rewards, is very powerful. If your cryptocurrency, your smart contract platform is not staking, it's at a huge disadvantage. And it's all about the barrier to entry too, because it's not all about huge multi-billion or multi-million dollar institutions gambling on interest rate swaps. They could be very small local mom and pop banks. They could be small mom and pop businesses that are working with, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars, or tens of thousands, or even thousands of dollars, or even hundreds of dollars. It all depends. You know, there's various institutions of various different sizes. I mean, think about, we're working with the unbanked here. Think about if there's a small little financial institution that maybe has a few thousand dollars for the people that live within that ecosystem, or a few hundred dollars for the people that live within that ecosystem, and they're using that money, they're staking, they're investing, they're hedging their earnings or their savings or their speculation, and they're hedging it in ADA, and they're hedging it against Shelley, and they're using Shelley as a tool in order to continue generating. So it's all about the way you look at it. So I think there are many different incentives to hold ADA as a native cryptocurrency. And I don't know, what are your thoughts? Let me know if you have any other use cases. I'm probably going to make this a series, because I'm thinking of another one right now as I speak. And please like, comment, and subscribe. And until the next video, thank you.